Joe Eberhardt, the man who runs Jaguar Land Rover North America.
Good morning.
Right in front of the I-Pace, which was just named World Car of the Year. How are you feeling about demand so far?
I mean, it's been a great morning for us. Not only were we named World Car of the Year, we were World Design Car of the Year and World Green Car of the Year. So the first time a manufacturer has won the three major awards, really incredible. Demand, I mean, we just started going on sale, but clearly the interest in this car is phenomenal. And for a small company like us to be leading the field really says a lot about our innovation and technology.
Where are the buyers coming from? Are they coming from other electric cars that they are trading in? Are they coming from standard internal combustion models that they have said, I don't want to drive that anymore, I want to go electric?
Yeah, they come from everywhere. I mean, there's not too much electric vehicles out there in the car park, so most of the early buyers are really coming from traditional vehicles, but we get them from our own, within Jaguar, within Land Rover, and then clearly also from competitive makes.
How much is Brexit making it a bit of a hassle right now, trying to figure out world production as well as world supply?
Yeah, it keeps us up awake at night, obviously. It's really hard to plan because it changes at such a rapid pace. You know, a hard Brexit would have been really an issue for us. Hopefully, we will find a negotiated way over the next couple of months, and then we'll see how to...
You took an extra week of downtime in anticipation of a hard Brexit, and now the question becomes, do you have any production issues, let's say, if things get lumpy over the next couple of months?
No, I mean, for the time being, we should be okay. But again, if there were a hard Brexit in the future, that's really hard to anticipate and plan for. But we're good for now.
You are in the cusp of this transition that's happening around the country and around the world in terms of electric vehicles catching on. Do you finally sense that we're seeing the transition in consumer attitudes? Maybe that they're not going out and buying electric, but they're finally considering it?
Oh, absolutely. It's now part of the conversation, right? At first, it was just the early adopters that wanted to be ahead of the curve. Now it's part of every car buying conversation. Should we consider an electric vehicle? We've overcome a lot of the issues. Range is, you know, 240-mile range. The performance is phenomenal. The driving dynamics is unlike any other car. So customers are starting to really see the benefit of an electric vehicle as an everyday commuting vehicle. It's part of the conversation. I do think, though, the adoption will be a couple of decades before we see the majority of cars being electric vehicles.
Land Rover.
Yeah.
Once again, the fastest growing brand in the U.S.
Absolutely.
And yet, and this is nothing new to you, and we've done reports on this, you guys consistently come in at the bottom or near the bottom in terms of reliability and dependability. What's the problem there?
Well, I think, you know, we have grown quite rapidly, and as part of that, we still have to work out some of the issues you mentioned, but we clearly, a lot of them are electronics-based, and we have a program in place to fundamentally transform that part of the business. The good news is that we have two brands that are iconically British, that people really want. The design is phenomenal, the technology is there, and our engineering colleagues are working really hard to fix the rest, at which point then I think the sky is the limit.